Hello everyone, a very good morning to all of you students. Welcome back to the session of the subject Building Construction Technology. This is Ishani Trivedi from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. So students, we have been discussing about the concept regarding the masonry construction. And we have been discussing in the last session about the next masonry construction after studying the basic types, that was your brick masonry, stone masonry, composite masonry, hollow concrete blocks and cavity walls, right? So now as we move further, we are moving with certain special kinds of masonry construction which are also inevitable. You will have to construct it in your conventional, in your traditional structures also. So one by one we are discussing about all kinds of masonry construction which are important to us and have to be studied in detail. Okay, so in the last session students, we discussed about which concept, that was lintels. Now let us recall quickly what is a lintel. It is the horizontal structural member which is provided across any opening in the structure to carry and transmit the loads safely. Okay, now likewise, similarly, just like arches, what we are going to provide is an arch construction. What is an arch construction? Okay, let us have a look over here. Now start from the left picture at the top, the first picture which you can see. What is an arch construction? Okay, now arc shape means a curved shape is provided. Okay, so across any openings, if you are not providing lintels, then sometimes you can do is, if the span is more, if you want a better aesthetic view, or sometimes if the loads coming are very much heavy, then in those cases you can provide a construction known as arch. It means a curved shape structural member, a curved shape structural member which is provided across the opening of the building, of the room, that is known as arch. Now in the lintels we studied that the load coming from the top will be carried by the lintel, it will be transmitted safely to the surrounding side walls. Now somewhat similar is the working of an arch construction. For the arch, even you will have more load distribution area, right, as compared to the simple type of lintels. So here the load coming from the structure will be transferred, it will be spread, and then it will be transferred and carried by the surrounding load safely, which you can also see over here in the first image. Can we see that the load will be coming directly on the crown, on the center portion of the arch. Then with the help of the blocks which are constructed, the arch which is constructed, it will transfer the loads in both the direction equally, and then it will transfer to the supports which will be provided immediately below the arch, which will be called as abutments. We shall be discussing about the technical terms in detail as we move further. So here the action is like, the arch action is like, the load will be coming at the center, it will be distributed in both the directions, and then it will be transferred safely into the supports, and then to the immediate structure or the structural member coming below it, be it foundation or the next floor or whatsoever, right? So such is the kind of the construction which is known as arches. Okay, now about the arch, if you want to define technically, right, how will you define technically an arch? So let us see over here. I have the technical definition. We have as arches defined as the structure constructed of wedge shaped blocks. Now if you want to construct an arch, then exactly rectangular or square shape is not going to make a curved structure. You will have to cut your block in some certain shape, right? So the shape in which your block is cut is known as wedge shape, which will give you the effect of curving part, right? So the arch construction which is done with the help of wedge shaped blocks, right, of stones or bricks, it can be even concrete member, it can be any material, right, and they are joined together with mortar. Obviously the bonding between them will be done with the help of cement mortar or lime mortar, and what does it say? It is provided across the opening to carry the weight of the structure above the opening. This is what I discussed right now in simple terms. The full thing which I discussed in simple terms is shown in technical words over here. This is how you are supposed to write down the technical definition of an arch construction. What else does it say? Because of the wedge shape. Now, as I told you that exactly square or rectangular shape is not going to help you achieve the curving shape. So, because of this wedge shape, where you are achieving the curving part, there is one more advantage that blocks will support each other, right? Here, interpressure is going to generate, right? Because the blocks are so arranged, they are closely packed and arranged to each other, because they will exert pressure in opposite direction to each other, they will keep the arch construction stable. Such kind of interpressure which is generated on each other is going to keep your arch construction stable as well. So this is a benefit of providing the wedge shaped blocks. It says the blocks will support each other by the mutual pressure. The proper word for it will be mutual pressure, and the structure in position by resistance from the supports, right? The supports are going to resist it. It is going to resist the load, carry the load, and the wedges will create mutual pressure on each other, and this is how your full geometry is going to remain constant. It is going to remain stable. You can also see certain examples over here about the arch construction. Not just over the opening, not just over the doors and windows, you can also construct huge arch bridges also. Generally your bridge slab is supported on arch. This is how your load is transferred. So you can go for large spans, very large spans, up to 1 meter span, that is in your windows or your doors. You can construct arch construction. You can do it anywhere, ranging from smallest opening up to a very large opening. The one you can see over here is the first image which you can see is situated in New Delhi, right? You know that about the India Gate. And the second one you can see is the arch construction, memorial arch, which is situated in France. There are so many monuments existing in the world heritage sites where arch construction was practiced very much. Stone arches are very much common. You would have seen that how it is existing all over. You can also see in the temples and mosques. I can also say that a dome structure is also one kind of arch structure, a curved structure as well. Okay, so now let us discuss first about the technical terms related to arch. Okay, now let me show you the cross-sectional image over here. Can you see that? I think yes, you can see the cross-sectional image. I am flashing all the technical words over here and we will study them one by one. So first of all, what do we have? We have an arch construction over here. A cross-sectional image is shown. You are also supposed to draw this if it is asked in exam. And also I will make it clear to you that technical terms of an arc are most commonly asked in your exams, in your descriptive exams. So here, let us start with the curving part, with the arch. Okay, now the center portion, the center of the arc. Now first of all, you know that arch will be constructed with the help of wedge shaped blocks. Now those wedge shaped blocks by which you are constructing the arch, let us give it a name. Those are known as view source. Can we find it over here? Do we have a view source? Yes, the 12th definition. Okay, so the wedge shaped blocks which are used to construct the arch are known as view source. Next, let us go to the first center part, starting from the top. At the center part, can you see crown is written? Yes, you can see that. So that particular view source, the central view source of an arc at the top, is known as crown. That block is known as crown. That top part is known as crown. Next, let us talk about the curving part. The top curvature, that is the outer curvature, and inner curvature. The outer curvature is known as extrados and the inner curvature is known as intrados. So how many definitions did we study? We have view source, we have crown, that is the central part. The crown name itself says that it is the center part, right? And then we have extrados and intrados, correct? Now let us discuss about the keystone. I think keystones are not shown over here, but the last wedges, right? On the both sides. On the both sides, the last view source on which are resting on the support, you can call them as keystone. Next we have is rise, right? I think rise and span. The name itself says that you can define how to write them. So the imaginary line, or let us say the vertical distance between the intrados of the arch and the line joining both the supports, the clear vertical distance is known as rise. And likewise, the clear horizontal distance between the two supports of an arch is known as span. Okay, next we have is abutment and pier. What is abutment? Now, when the arch is constructed, it will have supports right at the ends. It will have two supports at the ends. Those two supports at the extreme ends are known as abutment. Next, if you are providing an arch such that its span is long, then intermediate supports will have to be also provided. Those intermediate supports will be known as piers, and the extreme supports will be known as abutments. Next we have is soffit. Soffit means the underneath side width of the arch. The underneath of the arch, that width is known as soffit, right? Next we have is springing line. Now, the keystones, imaginary line joining the keystones, right, you can call it as the springing line. Okay, so moving forward now, let us discuss about the classification of arch. Okay, so now, as I told you generally lintels are classified based on the construction material, but here arch will be classified based on three parameters. The construction material being the common in all type of classification. If you talk about any structural members classification, then based on material, parameter is going to always stay, because you can construct all the structural members using different kind of structural members, that is your material. Now, what do we have over here? First classification is based on construction and workmanship. So it says brick arches, it says stone arches and concrete arches. So this becomes your construction material based classification of an arch. Further, these will also be subdivided. We will divide the brick arches into three types. We will divide the stone arches into two types. We will discuss about the same. Then we have is classification based on shape of curve formed by the soffit or the intrados. Now you know what is intrados, that is the inner curvature, inner curving portion. You know what is soffit, that is the underneath side width of the arch. Now, the classification will be based on shape of the intrados. It can be flat arc, it can be segmental, it can be circular, it can be semicircular. So, it will depend. And last classification we have is based on number of centers. Now, if we talk about circular arch, then it will have only one center. If you talk about semicircle, then it will have two centers, right? So, how you are constructing the arc? If you imagine taking a center and constructing a circle with the help of a protractor, then how you will decide number of centers, and based on that you will draw the arcs and you will connect your arch. This is based on the geometry, right? Based on the geometry, based on number of centers which you are taking to plot the arc and form the full arch construction, that is your based on number of centers. Now, let us discuss about the classification of the arch. Now, as I told you that brick arches will be further subdivided into three categories. What are those categories? Talking about the first one, in the brick arch, the first classification we have is rough brick arches. The first classification that we have is rough brick arches. Now, look at the image flashing over here. What can you see? Can you see that the bricks are not cut to a proper wedge shape? They are not properly made into shape of U source, right? They are somewhat used in its natural condition. Okay, so rough brick arches are used, they are constructed, and ordinary bricks are used in the construction of rough brick arches. The joints are made wedge shape over here. What happens is you are not cutting the bricks, you are not taking extra efforts, or you are not spending budget for the cutting of bricks into wedge shape. Rather, you are making the joints wider and then you are making those joints into wedge shape, right? So the thickness will be varying from top to bottom. Next, the wedge-shaped joints spoil the appearance. That is obvious thing. Look at the image flashing over here, and the ones which I will show you further, you will be liking them more. So it spoils the appearance. But here, the basic ordinary bricks are used, and the joints will be made to wedge shape. No extra efforts are made to cut these bricks into wedge shape. Those type of first classification in the brick arch is rough brick arches. Second, what do we have? We have axed brick arches. Right now, axed brick arches means the brick here will be cut to proper wedge shape. Right? The difference between the first and second, here joints are not made wedge. Here you will take some efforts to cut your bricks into wedge shape. The image you can see over here, that how this is more having pleasing appearance as compared to the first one. So that becomes your axed brick arches. It means you will axe the bricks, you will cut the bricks into the wedge shape, and your construction will be done. The third type of brick arch is gauge brick arches. Now, in the gauge brick arches, exactly view source, exactly wedge shape bricks will be used over here. Now you can also understand that the bricks are a little bit tough to cut them into wedge shape, right? Because they are very hard and strong material. Here the bricks will be specially made for arch construction. Here rubber bricks will be made using clay material. So here it will become very much easy to cut them into wedge shape, and then your arch will be constructed, which will have a very great appearance and the quality will also be better. So that becomes your third type, known as gauge brick arches. The joints here will be very much less thick. It will be around 1.6 mm thick only, the bed joints. You can see over here, this is your example of an relieving arch, right? I will explain to you what is a relieving arch. We will talk about that. But you can see over here how perfectly it is designed. The depth you can see is 2 brick thickness. So this is your gauge brick arches. Next, talking about the stone arches. In the stone arches, we will have again 2 different classification. Have we classified the stone masonry? Yes, we have classified that as rubble masonry and ashlar masonry. The same will be classification over here. We will have rubble arches and we will have ashlar arches. You know the difference between these 2 type of stone masonry construction. You can see for yourself over here how both of them vary, both of them differ. And rubble stones are hammer dressed. They are not properly into wedge shape, right? They will be used randomly. You can see over here in front of you. Okay, this makes your stone arches. Next, we are going to talk about classification. The next classification based on the construction material, and the last one in fact, that is your concrete arches. Now, you know about the concrete material. We have talked about concrete lintel also. So here we will have 2 categories. We will have cast in situ and we will have precast. Now, you can call the precast arch construction as monolithic arches as well. So when the span is more, when you want to provide up to 3 meter span, let us say that if you are going for more than 1.2 meter span, then you will have to provide precast arches. For that, you can see the construction over here, the image which is flashing in front of you. The material, the arch will be made such that the precast sections will be made such that 2 equal halves will be constructed, and then they will be placed at the site and joint will be made, and this is how your precast arch construction will be done. For the cast in situ, you will have to provide the centering, which we have studied in the formwork as well. So with the help of temporary structure known as centering, you will construct step by step the construction of cast in situ arch. Now moving forward with the next classification, which we have based on the curve formed by the intrados, right? That is the based on the shape. First, what do we have? We have flat arch. The name itself says the arch will be flat, right? It again, it becomes a type of a lintel itself. You can say that if you ask me. This makes your flat arch, okay? Next, second we have is semicircular arch. It means it will be two-centered arch. You can say that. So two centers will be used. Two arcs can be made and then it can be connected. So that becomes your semicircular arch. You can also have a circular arch as well. Circular opening can be provided in the structure. Then we have a segmental arc. You can see that segmental arc is constructed with two bricks. The shape will be somewhat having curvature. That is your segmental arc. Next we have is relieving arch. Now relieving arch will be a combination of arch and lintel, right? The lintel will be provided below the arch, which will be connecting the two supports of the arch for the purpose of load carrying and load distribution, right? When the loads coming are very much heavy, you will have to transfer that load again with the help of another horizontal structural member, that is known as relieving arch. And the last we have is Dutch arch. The name itself says the origin is from that place, so that becomes your Dutch arch. Again, there you can say that this is an example of a segment of a flat arch also, not segmental. It can be said as a flat arch. So this is just the matter of the different shapes. Nothing else is very much complicated over here. And the last type of construction we have is arch construction based on number of centers. As I told you, if you plot a circle, then you will have only one center. And then based on that, by providing number of centers and you connect those arches, then you have one centered arc, then you have two centered, right? In that you will be joining two arcs, so you will have two centers. Likewise, up to five centered arches you can go and construct. Again, this will be having the shape like circular or segmental or Dutch arc. This is going to repeat, but here it is a matter of the geometry. Okay, students, so this covers your arch construction in detail. Then it also covers your lintels and arches. Now we will discuss further in the next session some more topics regarding masonry works. Till then, have a good day, students. Thank you.